at the New York Hall of Science. Hey, what helps a boat to float?
Let's find out.
Oh, boy.
Today we're going to be doing an experiment, and we're going to be working in teams of two, and we're going to be using this aluminum foil to build a boat. So we're going to take a look at each boat and see what exactly is helping it float better than the other one. What is something that is really important to have in a good boat? What do you think?
It has to be strong. Otherwise, it'll be flimsy and it can break apart.
I think that's good advice for boat building? All right, let's get to building.
Oh boy, let's design our boats.
Once you guys are done designing your boats, we're gonna be testing them in the water to test whether the boat floats or sinks by placing these washers in them one at a time to see how many washers they'll hold. So remember, keep in mind, you need to design your boat to hold as many washers as possible.
I got my boat. Wow, these are some great boat designs. We'll test them in a few minutes. What made you design your boat like that?
I thought that it will hold more if the walls are taller.
Let's see if your boat can hold weight. Put it in the water. It's floating. Now put in some of the washers. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Your boat held seven washers. Great job. Why did you design your boat to look like that?
Because it would be stable and float.
Let's test out your boat and see if it can hold weight. Held 11 washers and then it sank. We'll test some more boats in a few minutes. Put it in the water and let's add some weight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Oh, fell over on seven. Good job, you guys. How did you design your boat?
Flat in the bottom.
Put it in the water and start adding weight. Eight. Nine, ten. Up! Oh, it held ten, and then it sank. Now it's time to test my boat. One, two, three, four, five. Oh, mine only held five. Ah, these boats held weight, but this wide boat held the most. Wow, those are some great boat designs.